between 5 and 5, of course, the function is right here. So this is nice. All the r's are positive. So this is the area I want to find, just this part right here. So again, we're going to fold this. Let's move the 1/2 out. So when I fold, I get 1 plus 2 sine theta plus sine squared. And this becomes what? The sine squared.
Minus cosine 2 theta over 2.
Okay. So then we can simplify. 1 plus 1/2 would be 3/2. So when I integrate, I have 3/2 theta. Anti derivative of 2 sine is minus 2 cosine. And anti derivative of negative cosine 2 theta would be over 2, would be negative 1 over 4 sine of 2 theta. Between 5 to 2 and 5. And then we substitute 5 into 5 to 2. So at 5 I'll have, we have 5. Cosine of 5 would be negative 1, so it's plus 2. And sine of 2, pi is 0. Minus, at 5 to 2, we have 3/2 5 to 2 is 3 pi/4. Minus 2 cosine of 5 to 2 is 0, of course. And then minus 1 over 4, sine of 5 would be 0 again. So actually, we just have 1/2 times 3 pi/2 plus 2 minus 3 pi/4.
Yes.
Shut up.